Hello and welcome back to Final Fantasy X The Wrong Way, Part 13. Lastly, we just went through the Thunder Plains and now we are in Macalania Woods. We got a lot of ground to cover today, so let's get right on it. Oh, I missed this chest right here. It's a sneaky chest. And I still did not manage to pick it up. You remember, this was something that we fought early on in the ruins after we left Xanarkand. It's really nice to try to dark this thing, but it's kind of resilient to it. So another thing you can do is also just beat it until it dies. I'm gonna cheer because the damage that I'm gonna do from Tidus is so much smaller than the damage Waka will do after a cheer. I do have Dark Buster. I could have gone for that. Probably should have, actually. But Lulu has such high evasion, it doesn't really matter. So, look at that. We're now getting into the 300 damages with Tidus's magic. Fantastic. I do have Dark Buster. I'm gonna actually go for it. This should hopefully land and give me one turn. Okay, it did. Great. Alright, so we've got that, so we got one turn to switch. I'm gonna hope to pull out poison out of this thing. Darn, my potion. Very rare chance. Bring in an Orin. Damage. Not Waka. Wrong one. Yuna. Delay is somewhat effective against these things, but not too much. Give me my last turn to switch in Kamari. Do the damage and get it done with. Pretty clean. Took one hit on the start of the battle, but it's not that bad. So I'm gonna try my best to keep my formation as Riku, Tidus, and Yuna, because they are my fastest agility-wise. We're gonna equip that straight to Lulu right now. So she doesn't have a Moogle, but this has Sleep Touch, which has a small chance of trying to inflict sleep. Then it has to go through a secondary check to see if the monster is resistant to it or if it's immune to it. Oh, that's bad. It's probably resistant to water, isn't it? Yeah. Gonna need to switch Waka's Ball now.
Okay. This ends now.
Hopefully we can get through this, even though it's resistant to magic and it's gonna duck down. No. Tried. Ooh, that does damage. And that's bad. So we bring in Kimari. We Yasuna ourselves back into existence. And we Bushido Dragon from these guys.
Away!
Down left. Down left, up right. Yeah. We'll finish off the two, which leave me. I don't have the thunder up yet, so I'm not gonna be able to do much damage. Well, cool, new overdrive. There's an easy way to get around this thing. I have null tide and it only does water. At this point, I am free to swap in the rest. Gonna go steal a water gem from it. Oh, fish scale. Nice. Gonna bring Yuna in, and I'm gonna try to delay it. Okay, delay is gonna be very effective if it is not immune to it. Generally, most of the base monsters at this point in the game are not immune to it. Gonna bring Kamari, just gonna heal. Gonna need to heal out of the party too. Gonna need to do that a couple times this run through. There's quite a lot of things that are gonna put a pretty decent sized dent in me. Hit the last person that was in there. That's beautiful. Alright, so while we're here, we might as well just lightning strike, or just give him. I'm gonna give him the plus 10% strength because some of these things are pretty nice to, pretty good with lightning and weak to ice, and some are not. And it'd be much better to just have the damage out flat. Alrighty.
Thinking isn't solving anything.
That was pretty denting to my health bar. Let's heal up using Mari, secondary white mage. See if we can get. Next one is gonna be water. Darn. So I need two more levels, and give me what? Thundara. Okay, so we need two more levels on Tidus, so that way we can get Thundara. Mario's not going to really learn anything too new. He's going to get some magic defense, which is great. Let's move Yuna over one. She's going to get some evasion, and is going to get some accuracy, which will help her hit some things. Sadly, she's not getting strength for another two levels, which will probably be two, yeah. It'll bring her up to a strength of 11, which she will then hit on par with Lulu's damage. That is okay, because Lulu's job is to actually just hit and inflict statuses. We don't really need to worry too much if she misses. If she doesn't do a lot of damage. We need to worry if she misses, that's what I mean to say. Not worth it. As per usual, since this is Orin's grid, there's going to be a lot of empty nodes here. It's this way. Slow. Okay, so that's Tidus's grid. It's kind of nice to see how here's Waka's grid, and Orin's grid is kind of coiled around it. That'll give us, what, Sloka? Level 1, I will do that, because I'm going to have to go here to spend one level to grab Sloga on Waka would be pretty large. He's got a enormously small pile of mana, but it'll be fine. And you got four more strength here, four more strength here, four more strength here. If I can get him to this side of the grid, he's going to be ending up getting 16 more strength, which is going to make him hit in the 2 to 3,000 area. Hopefully. That'll be pretty huge. I don't want to touch those butterflies. That's pretty bad. Alright, she's fine. Knock the thing out of the sky. Gonna bring in Kamari. As we did in the Thunder Plains for the double elementals, we would just, we're gonna put immunity up on everyone. We're gonna silence one of them. Silence. Hopefully. Okay, we're good. Now with silence on one, I can freely swap around and try to get it down and out as quickly as possible.
Gotcha covered!
Black magic. Thunder. Need a bit more damage. And just guard with them. It doesn't do as much. We're also going to silence the second one. Or we're going to try it, basically. Alright, the silence is good, and now we are basically free to do as we please. Gonna bring in Yuna. Going to try to make the silence last a little bit longer. Alrighty. We need Riku to try to get those fish scales, maybe a water gem, if we're lucky. Fish scales again. That'll be good for later on. And now that we've basically given everyone a turn, we're gonna start killing off one of these two. Waka's not had his turn. Oh, he has had a turn. What am I saying? Everyone's had a turn. Thunder. Skill up. And not sleep. Silence. Keep it nice and quiet. Since Yuna doesn't have any magic of her own, we're just gonna lance it for 161 damage. That's on par with Tidus's damage. And it's a pretty quick move. Costs no mana to do. Yeah, it actually does more than Tidus. That's kind of sad. Be a waste, but I don't want it to have a turn. He only does 169. That's really sad that Yuna outdamages him with a non-mana consuming move. Tidus the bad mage. Ugh, my voice. I was playing another game. I was playing Summoner's War from the stream yesterday, and I randomly pulled a 0.02% chance or 0.2% chance pool from a... I got really good odds on me, and I got really excited, and I probably garnered one or two noise complaints. We haven't gotten those yet, but we'll see. Oh, this is bad. But yeah, my voice is still not recovered from that yet. I don't think I have Threaten yet. Gonna delay it. What did it say? It's Darkness and Silence, vulnerable to Threaten. I have, like... I can attempt. Oh, and it landed, too! That is fantastic, and if we can get silence on, we'll be good to hit this thing down. The silence didn't go through. So, you notice how there was that crystal that appeared on it, but it didn't say immune? Because the crystal was telling me that it was immune to being sleep. To the sleep status effect. I'm gonna need to hit these things with my heavy hitters. It's got 5,000 health, and that's a lot. We're gonna try silence one more time. Also going to swap in Kamari. Is the silence there? I don't think so. Yeah, just darkness. Alright, so we're gonna bring in Waka. Waka's back on the field, folks. Ooh. So someone's going down with this. It's just... Took it to the face like a champ. Bring in... Not Riku. Definitely not Riku. Mari's turn. We're gonna keep Orin at least alive enough that he will survive the next hit. I know I don't have threat. Yeah. So it casts water, fire, lightning in that order. Tidus hasn't done anything.
No problem.
Still feel like it's more better to just slap it with the sword. Yeah, the physical damage doesn't do a lot. It is a chimera, and it does a lot of magic damage. Arctic Wind is pretty nice. Should be able to kill it, yeah. Especially with a crit. Absolutely dead with a crit. Tidus hits that two levels needed to get that next magic, so we're gonna grab it for him real quick. And of course we need to heal everyone else up. So we got Thundara, which will help with those water elementals if we run into them again. Yuna's gonna get a little bit more strength. Not too big, though. You don't know how tempting it is to just use a few levels to go and grab all second-tier magic for Lulu, but that's not her job, so I'm not going to do that. Alright, she's got a little bit more health, which is nice. Mari's gonna get nothing for her next few levels. But he'll be getting his way over to Cura, and then we're gonna get Protect, Shell, Reflect, Dispel. And it's gonna get some needed HP increased. Even though he's kind of, more of a... just a damage dealer than a tank right now, he still seems to take a lot of hits. Alright, we're good. Mari's got 105 mana remaining, so no harm in just using it. See, the problem with the Macalania Woods is you get turned around so easily. And I think I actually might be turned around facing the wrong way. Get everyone EXP for it, but it's alright. Okay, cool. I am not going the same way.
You have you seen Donna?
Donna? Can't say I have.
What's up?
We got separated on the way here. Damn it all! I've got to find her!
Calm down.
But if anything happens to her...
Running around in a panic is not going to help. Right now, you have to keep cool and search.
But...
Guard your emotions, then guard your summoner.
You're right.
Shall we search?
No, I've taken up enough of your time. Thank you, Sir Aran.
What's up?
Oh, I just wanted to wish him good luck.
Alright, so we have another summoner that's missing in action. Ooh. So this is why you bring softs with you forever. Because if he's my healer, my white mage, and if that happens to him, I need to be able to bring him back into the game. We're in a predicament here. So, we're actually gonna spiral cut this thing. Hopefully,
I've been saving this one for you!
There's enough damage. We'll see. I have no faith that it will. And I was wrong. Thankfully, it did damage. Okay, so Kamari's actually still not had his turn. We're gonna try to get his health, some of his mana back. And by that, I mean I'm going to get his mana back. That's pretty easy. I didn't want you enough. Now I want Oren back. So bring in Oren.
This ends now.
And do a chunk of damage to it. Then bring in Lulu. And also cast magic on. See if this how much damage this does. That's pretty good. So now we have Thundara, so this should hit for like 450 damage. That's respectable. That's now in Lulu's base area of damage. Like, this is her thunder. 700 damage. And he's on tier 2 magic, guys. This is fantastic for me. steal. Yeah, it's dead. Warren's moved. Mari's moved. Waka has not moved. Neither is Yuna. Can I get a delay? Oh man, that's a beautiful delay. Let me bring in Waka again. He doesn't know anything. Just gonna guard it and get it out of here. In all honesty, you should be able to one-shot these things. If you're playing it correctly. I am not playing it correctly, therefore I cannot. Yeah, we are not touching these rainbow butterflies. It's a minigame. It's frustrating. It's confusing. And it will get us killed. If we were going to do this, we'd have to come back to it a lot later.
A butterfly with rainbow wings will lead the way to secret things.
Once we have the option to come back to Macalania Woods and start a little bit of Pharaoh. Now in the second zone. Okay. And fine. That is all fine and dandy. I'm going to just guard and let the poison do its damage. It's not gonna be too bad. Yeah, 185 is fine. But it allows me to get a secondary turn with her. Which allows me to swap her out. Shoo shoo fly, don't bother me. Be on that overkill. Actually, Tidus knows dark attack. There's a very, very small chance it'll hit, but we can try. Yeah. Didn't think it would. It's got 2,000 health, now it's got 1,900. I'm gonna steal another high potion from it because I'm very not sure that I will get a good steal out of it. Bring in Orin. Orin's now starting to do less and less damage. Like, 300 damage is nothing. I should probably start using him to steal even though his agility's terrible. Well, Yuna's already had a turn. What am I doing? Mari needs his turn though. Bring Tidus back in.
My turn now!
280 damage. That is horrible. Alright, so Walker's our damage dealer. It's gonna have to be for a while. That was fairly decent damage for a Lancet. How much do you want? 41 damage. Oh my god, that's horrible.
Take that!
Alright. Well. Still pretty successful in my opinion. Two level ups for some, one for others. Some health and evasion. Or agility, not evasion. Agility is nice for Waka. He's got pretty decently high agility, but the thing is, all the other really slow ones are starting to catch up to him, which is less nice. There we go. There's our final tier 2 magic for Tidus. We've got 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 10 more levels he needs to get before he gains an additional 4 magic. Okay. Okay, that's a 1 magic and 1 magic. That's for 2 magic and 40 mana. That is not worth the 3 level investment to go through this level 1 key sphere. So we're not going to do that. 3 agility is a pretty huge number. 4 is the highest you can get for all non-double digit or health stats. Orn's gonna get 3 more agility as well, and 2 strength if I remember correctly. Yes, 2 strength indeed. Spare change, which is a very interesting ability, that's damage is proportionate to how much money you throw at them. Now that's not very nice for me. I kind of need my money. I'm gonna be saving it up for possibly buying off Yojimbo at some point. If I go down that route. I may or may not spend it. I really need to leave that alone.
Well then, what next?
Okay, so there's that. I was hoping for a crit, and I was not let down. Perfect. Titus, or the tier 2 magics, of very, very low damage. I'm gonna steal off those fish scales. We're gonna attempt for a double steal. So every time you successfully steal, it gets harder and harder to steal. I could sit here and spam stealing and get another item. It's just, it'll take a long while. Attack, haste, shell. I bring in Yuna, because even though her job is the hitter, I still get to use cure. Her magic is starting to get behind Kamari's just a little bit. Alright, so we are set to kill it. Kamari's had a turn. Only one that hasn't had a turn is the Lulu. Well, she's had a turn, but we need her to finish this off. Perfect. Remedy, always nice. Remedies get rid of all status effects except Zombie and Unholy, if I remember correctly. I'm not too sure about that. I don't know Slow yet, do I? Oh, that's bummer. Slow would be so nice here. There's really nothing for me to do besides delay. I'm gonna bring in Kamari. And since he is going to do water off the start, I think we're just going to follow along. We finally hit the point where we outdo our damage with magic, so that's a pretty substantial achievement. Someone as poor for magic as Tidus is. Sweet. We can swap into Orin, who I am not going to steal with.
I see no difficulty.
We got a lot of damage to go through this thing, so we might as well hit it. Gonna leave him in. Actually, gonna swap Waka in now and throw the ball at it for the best damage available in the game. We've hit damage cap now, guys. Not allowed to go any higher than that. We're gonna null blaze, even though it's a single target damage, I just don't wanna have to deal with it. It is cheaper to null blaze than it is to heal it. Right, get Riku in. She'll be the one that steals the Arctic Wind. Nice. Lulu gets brought back in. in first time.
Allow me.
And we're gonna just we're gonna lance it. Blue is really low on mana. That didn't do me anything. That's bad. Alright, well, we're gonna need to wait until we find a elemental for Lulu, because she's incredibly low.
As you wish.
I was hoping I was going to be able to get through this before. Left it with 15. That's a shame. Thankfully, Kamari has the mana and droves for this. Abilities, care, yourself, twice. Walk it 3 times because Walk has so much health. And we keep moving. Almost out of here. Alright, that's what we're looking for. We've got ourselves a wonderful, wonderful elemental. Which should be able to give us all of Lulu's magic back again. Lancet is always such a really nice thing to have Lancet on a lot of characters, especially your casters. Tidus is very low, and he does have Lancet. That's nice. I didn't think he did. It's not going to do a lot, especially since Lulu already took all the mana out of it. Bring Kamari back in. Just negate the damage with Null Tide. Riku to steal. That'd be good. Swap Kamari out to Yuna and just have her guard. Yeah, we got everyone. Alright, moving right along. That is a huge increase for evasion. Sadly, his evasion's a little low on to start with, but it'll get better. Orin probably at this rate is gonna outdo Tidus in magic. He's got 10 magic over Tidus's 12. That is sad. I really need Tidus to learn magic. Yeah, I was going this way, I believe. Don't touch the rainbow butterfly. I
Allow me.
Pokemon is not a lot, but it's something. We have a save sphere, and we get to attempt a boss battle. Take a breath. I need to adjust my party before I go into this.
Wait. It is here. Somewhere.
What's here?
Something you should see.
But, Sir Orin...
It won't take long.
Oh good, we get to actually get a few, do one or two level ups. It's a shame, I'd really like haste. I'd really like slow for this, but... It's all the way down there. That's okay, we'll be fine without it. It's immune to slow, but having slow just means I'll be closer to Hastiga, which allows me to haste my entire party and not just one person. Formation of a wild tiger. Waka, Kamari, Orin. In that order, yep. I'm pretty sure this is gonna end up being a boss fight. And I am pretty certain that the it
this
is
place.
To physical and
it's
magic.
It's just water, breaking. Isn't it?
This is what spheres are made of. It absorbs and preserves people's memories.
What's that?
Fiends are also attracted to these places.
Okay, so... I did some damage. I want to see if I can power break it, but I'm pretty sure it's immune. No, it's not. Okay, so it's a fire. The sphere morph is an all-elemental creature. If you hit it with its elemental weakness, it will change to a random new element. It counterattacks physical attacks with magic. So we're gonna put in Null Blaze, and we're gonna put in some work on this thing. I'm gonna hope to get 3x cheer on Waka, just so that way he will do a little bit more damage. I'm going to keep him in as often as I can in this fight, and I'll swap the other two out as necessary. So I think that damage is proportionate to like 1/14th of your total health. Or is that hydraulic press? I think it's hydraulic press. So we're on 2 cheer. I should really be cheering with Yuna because she's much faster than Orin. But as long as I can keep him covered up with, I don't think it has anything to steal. An ether. That's not gonna do much. No, hydraulic press is the one that takes damage. So, if it is casting fire, then casting blizzard would be the correct thing to do. But doing that means it changes. Okay, and it gets absorbed with everything else.
It and absorbs when... all spells except its one weakness.
Okay, just making sure. Might as well bring back in him. Get rid of the fire. Just keep the threat of fire off of him. Now, what is the chances I can get ice on this? Pretty low because I'm bad at this. And hey, look at that. Managed to do it. Of 100 damage isn't bad. There we go with the elemental shift right before his turn. So that way, I have no idea what it is, and the only way to find it out is to hit him. Guy just hasn't have a turn yet. Cheering's probably the worst thing to do. Actually gonna keep Lulu in. And we're gonna figure out what this thing has. Thunder! Beautiful. So we're gonna null shock it. Bring in Yuna and just guard. Bring back in Tidus and cast Focus. The goal here is to just increase my magic. You have to beat this thing with magic, which is why it's really nice to have multiple. Will Drain actually hit it since it's not. Yeah, it's a non-elemental type. And it will counter. Perfect. We used Waka, we've used Orin, we've used everyone except Kamari. Now we've used Kamari a lot. What am I saying? Just focus again. So the easiest way around this thing is to just drain it. Because I can know what it's gonna cast every time I do this. And then plan accordingly. So we're at 2 focus, 3 focus. Should be getting close to 1,000 damage on drain. Yeah, the next one should bring me up to 1,000. So there's a very good telltale sign when it hits 50% health, if I recall correctly. And last focus. After that, I'm gonna start spamming luck. The moment it starts casting hydraulic press is when it's below 50% health. So that does 120 damage. I can easily counter that by just simply praying. Now, if I were to cast this, everyone would take damage. So we're going to actually, we're gonna pop its elemental change. It's funny how, even though that was its elemental weakness, it did more damage to just drain from it. I'm gonna also start cheering because it does physical damage and I would like to lower that. Get it down pretty low if we just keep our cheer on times 4. Alright, what have we got to deal with? Water! Beautiful. Null Tide. Set Cheer times 3. Since I already have my Null Tide out, I can pray to get some of my health back passively. Skill. Black magic, drain. since we've done that, we can then come down. Okay. Just the elements with a shift. I'm guessing fire. Well, there's one easy way to find that out. Oh, water again. That does happen sometimes. Or it just decides to do water twice in a row. I'm gonna lance at it to see if I can grab some mana back from it. Yeah, plenty. And since it wasn't considered magic, even though it is a magical attack, it's not from magic type. Okay, so we're a blizzard now. I had a really bad thought right there, which was, if it's at blizzard, which means it's weak to fire, go Kamari, self-destruct! That's really bad, and I shouldn't do it. I'm gonna get that last cheer on. And if we were at four, oh well, I was just stalling for Lulu to be able to drain. With the power grid and the time short cheer and focus, it's gonna have a hard time really damaging us. Especially with our impromptu white mage here. What do you got now? Thunder. Beautiful. And there's the press. Press does damage equal to a fourth or so of your maximum health. So there's no real way to reduce the damage I take from it, besides just passively trying to cure it off. I'm gonna water it. I don't want it to be lightning. But we've hit halfway. This isn't a hard fight, it's a long fight. Okay, we're at water. Great. And he's just gonna start spamming press. Which is problematic. A little bit. He's got no water on. Alright. Tidus is gonna take a little bit of damage for this. That's fine. Dandara. Oh hey, look at that! That went through a lot easier than I thought it would. I generally don't think you should have that much of a problem with him. Like I said, once you get him power broken and your ups, he doesn't really do too much damage. It's once he hits
Whoa, this is old. Don't know if you can play it back.
Jekt left it here 10 years ago. Play it back.
Mm-hmm.
What are you taking?
Well, you said it was gonna be a long trip. We'll be seeing a lot of neat things, right? So I thought I'd record it all in this. To show to my wife and kid, you know.
This is no pleasure cruise.
Hey, Braska. Ain't this supposed to be a grand occasion? We're the cheering fans, the crying women.
This is it. Too many goodbyes. People think twice about leaving.
If you say so. Well, it better be a lot more colorful when we come back. A parade for Braska, vanquisher of sin.
We should go. Day will break soon. Oren, Could you stand closer to him? Good. That should do it.
What's the matter? Afraid I might bite?
Jacked.
Braska, you should take one too. It'd make a great gift for little Yuna.
I suppose.
Lord Braska, we shouldn't be wasting our time like this.
What's the hurry, man?
Ugh. Let me tell you what the hurry is.
Auron.
What's the point? He wasn't on some pleasure cruise.
I think there's more.
Hey, if you're sitting there watching this, it means you're stuck in Spira like me. You might not know when you'll get back home, but you better not be crying. Although I guess I'd understand. But you know what? There's a time when you have to stop crying and move on. You'll be fine. Remember, you're my son. And, well, never mind, I'm no good at these things. Anyways, I believe in you. Be good. Goodbye.
He sounded almost serious, but it was too late.
He was serious. Jacked had already accepted his fate.
His fate?
Jacked, he... He was always talking about going home to Xanarkand. That's why he took all those pictures, to show them to you when he returned. But as he journeyed with us and came to understand Spira and Braska's resolve, it happened gradually, but Jekt changed. He decided he would join Braska in his fight against Sin.
So then, he gave up going home?
That was his decision.
I guess I understood. My old man, he knew there was no way back home, back to Xanarkand. He wanted to go home, but he knew he couldn't. He couldn't go on until he accepted it. Besides, even if he had found a way back, I don't think he would have left his friends behind before their journey was complete.
All right. Let's go, guys.
Maybe I had to start accepting my own fate.
Oh yeah, we just learned Orin's second overdrive, Shooting Star.
Wait.
Yeah?
Jekt loved you.
Oh, come on, please.
He just didn't know how to express it, he said.
Enough about my old man, okay?
I just thought you should know.
Okay. Thanks.
So, Auron learns new overdrives by finding Jekt spheres, where they get to relive their entire previous journey all over again. They're scattered all throughout Spira, and we're gonna have to backtrack for a lot of them if we want to get all of the overdrives for Auron. I don't plan on it. If anything, I might go out of my way a little bit to try to get enough Jekt spheres to get Banishing Blade, which is by far the most overpowered overdrive I can get for Auron, because it teaches him a early form of Full Break. It is unresistible Full Break, too. Full Break breaks everything. Magic, power, armor, everything. Everything gets knocked down. which becomes pretty crucial on some of the early on side quest fights. Oh wow, we're running low on monospheres. That's pretty bad. Well, we'll just have to go get more of those at some point. Alrighty though, that'll be it for this episode though. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that it was entertaining, and until next time, have a fantastic day.